Cliff Fletcher spent a very emotional day on Tuesday. The late president and general manager dealt two loyal soldiers, Doug Gilmour and Dave Ellett, to the New Jersey Devils. While Ellett's impact was noteworthy and Fletcher recognized his value, all Leaf fans, including Fletcher, realize that when we list out many of the greatest players in this franchise's history, Doug Gilmour will rank in the very elite. No one will forget his passion, his aggressiveness. He never attempted to take an easy stride. At both ends of the ice, he was the franchise's soul. No one will ever forget his spark, the fact that the franchise was carried and looked proud on his slight frame. Cliff and Leaf fans everywhere will not soon forget his six-assist night of genius, 1993 against Minnesota, or career point 1,000 recorded last season against Edmonton. He played hurt. He played hurt at the highest level. Guts and determination were his signature. His performances in postseason play were legendary. He scored goals and gave thrills not seen in these parts in a quarter of a century. Gilmour and Fletcher made magic in 1989 in Calgary. Gilmour scored the cup winner. Fletcher cheered then and did here in Toronto. Doug Gilmour, not just any player, he was the player on the franchise in the hockey town. The Leaf boss worked the phones looking for the right deal, the only deal for the Leafs' future. And he found it when talking to another veteran horse trader, New Jersey's Lou Lamoriello. New Leafs you'll see tonight and for the next few seasons as the club rebuilds include Steve Sullivan, a small package of dynamite who plays well beyond his 5'9", 150-pound frame. His offensive abilities have never been questioned, neither has his heart. Jason Smith is a defender of great promise, a regular in the Devils' blue line in 1997. His physical component comes packaged with a smart defense-first attitude craved by the Maple Leaf hockey team. Alyn McCauley won't be here tonight, but the Leafs hope he will take a regular turn at Maple Leaf Gardens in the seasons to come. This Ottawa 67 center is a blue-chip prospect with the prospect of playing a long time in Toronto. The two new Leafs that will play in the Maple Leaf uniforms this year, number 11, Steve Sullivan, number 25, Jason Smith, ready to debut against the Washington Capitals. Maple Leaf Gardens, the scene as the Leafs return home after a lengthy road trip with new players and a new outlook. Good evening, everyone. I'm Jim Taddy. Welcome to Molson Leaf Hockey on the Global Television Network. Anticipation high. We're standing here in the Zamboni entrance with Cliff Fletcher. Cliff, these are obviously three players you sought after and have obtained. What attracted you to them?
Well, first of all, Jersey offered us two young players who are playing regularly in the league on a pretty competitive hockey club and a terrific prospect playing junior in Ottawa. So if you had to trade a Doug Gilmour, and that was a very, very difficult decision because you never replace a player like Doug. I think it's going to be a great deal for the future of the Maple Leafs.
The trading of the captain talked about in the public for many months now. What was the actual lifespan of this deal? Was it weeks or months?
Well, only weeks, really, maybe 3 or 4 weeks. We were talking to four teams on a pretty regular basis, and the Jersey proposition was by far the best.
Quickly here, the trading deadline about 3 weeks away. Anything else?
Well, there could be. I mean, I'm not saying yes, I'm not saying no. We'll have to evaluate what options may be available to us between now and March 18th.
Thank you very much, Cliff. Let's go upstairs with more on this from Harry Neal. Harry?
Well, I think the Toronto fans are going to like Steve Sullivan. He's young, he's quick, he's smart, and he's feisty. And he's defied the law of size when he was a Bantam and midget player in Timmins, when he went to Sault Ste. Marie to play junior, when he led Albany to the Calder Cup, and now in the National Hockey League. So the Timmins Tornado is going to become a very popular Maple Leaf in a short time.
Thank you very much, Harry. There are the former Leafs. Doug Gilmour wearing number 93. Dave Ellett, number 2. New Jersey on Long Island tonight. So the Devils getting their new players, and the Leafs with two of their three new players. With more in the Maple Leaf deal, let's go over to Jake's McDonald.
Thanks, Jim. Mike Murphy's had just over 24 hours to think about this deal and what it means to his lineup. How are you going to use these guys, Mike?
Well, we'll use Sullivan at center between Ty Domi and Wendell Clark and see how it goes. I hope there's some chemistry there. I think the speed he has will help both Wendell and Ty. And we'll play Smith with McCowan. And McCowan's used to breaking in younger defensemen. And he played with Lefebvre when Lefebvre came here. And I see Smith as a player very similar to Lefebvre. So I think that could be a good pair.
What does this do to your specialty teams? Power play, penalty killing?
Well, we won't know for sure until we get out there and play in them. Obviously, losing Gilmour, who's played a lot of point for us and brings the puck up so well, is he's irreplaceable. But Sullivan will play in the power play, and we're going to move Matt Sundin back tonight and to see how it goes there. And we also, you know, we'll experiment with some other defensemen back there and see how it works out. But that's one area, the penalty killing. We're pretty well covered in the penalty killing. We can move Hendrickson into a more prominent role, and we've got Dempsey dressed tonight. And Sullivan did kill penalties when he was at Albany 2 years ago, so he has experience at it, and I think it's time that we might have to expand that experience in the NHL.
Thanks for your time, Mike. With more in the Leaf Homestand, here's Jim Tatt.